Hi guys, welcome to my channel Gym's Fun and Knowledge. Hi guys, this video is about structural behavior of stairs, which is very important topic and that you can also explain by types of stairs with respect to supports provided to it, with respect to end supports provided to it. Because as we know, complete load, whatever is coming on the steps, will transfer to the waste slab first of all. And from the waste slab, it will transfer to the end supports. You can see in these pictures, in first figure, you can see a stringer beam is used at the center of the stairs, center of the flight, where on both sides of the stringer beams, steps are acting like a overhanging or cantilever part on both sides. In this figure, you can see two stringer beams are used near to the ends of the step, and here no stringer beam is used, no waste slab is used, but still these stairs are taking loads. And in this figure also, you can see instead of any stringer beam, a waste slab is used throughout the flight and landing. So how to call these all types of stairs, we'll discuss now in detail in this video. The complete load transfer phenomena is completely depends on the members, that components. Here if we use stringer beam, then the phenomena will be different. If we used two stringer beams, then the phenomena will be different. If we used a waste slab instead of stringer beam, then phenomena will be, load transfer phenomena will be different. In this picture, stairs are known as cantilever stairs, and in this picture load transfer phenomena of cantilever stairs is completely different as compared to these figures. So can say, what will be the load transfer phenomena of the staircase? That will be completely depends on the components which we used and also end supports which we are going to provide to the stairs. Guys, one more important thing here, I used some technical terms such as waste slab, stringer beam, etc. These are the important components of stairs, and I already explained these all the components of stairs in a previous video, lecture 1 of the same concept stairs, and also a lecture 2 about different types of stairs with all important questions, interview questions, will discuss that. If you need that knowledge about components of stairs and types of stairs, I already provided a link of the both videos, lecture 1 and lecture 2, in description box. Just click on the links and watch that videos. That will be too beneficial for you guys to learn about stair components, the meaning of stairs and the types of stairs. One more very very important question I discussed in that video or lecture 1 of the stairs, that difference between stairs and staircase. Please click on the link and watch that video and learn the new knowledge about that concept.
If you are new on my channel, please subscribe it and press bell icon to watch my all upcoming videos first. So without wasting too much time, let's begin.
Before moving forward in this video, first of all, we should know about the two main components of the staircase or the stairs. First one is waste slab, the part of the stairs on which all the steps are resting. And the second main component is step, which comprises one tread and one riser. This triangular part resting on the waste slab known as step. So the load transfer phenomena is the load coming on the step, on the tread, on this horizontal part, and transferred to the waste slab. This is a waste slab, and that load coming on the waste slab transferred to the end supports. Whatever the end supports we are going to use, transfer to the end support. So this was the brief introduction about stairs and the load transfer phenomena and the two main components of it. Next, come to the very important part, types of stairs with respect to end supports. As we know, structural behavior of stairs is completely depends on the end supports. So the very first type is stair slab spanning horizontally. It is also known as stairs lap spanning transversely. First of all, the meaning of it is the stair slabs supported on both sides over the walls or beams, or you can say one side a stringer beam and the other side one wall is called stair slab spanning horizontally or transversely. Clear guys? In simple words, you can say if we are going to provide any end support parallel to the flight or perpendicular to the steps width. So this is a step, one step. So this one is step width. So perpendicular to step width, we are going to provide support. Or in other words, you can say that support is parallel to the flight. The meaning of flight is this inclined part, this inclined length of the stairs in which a series of steps are there, known as flight. So a end support which we are going to provide parallel to the flight on both sides of the step, maybe on one side, maybe at the center, known as stair slab spanning horizontally. See, this figure is showing a two stringer beams we used near to the ends of step, and that stringer beams are parallel to the flight. So can say this is stair slab spanning horizontally or transversely. In another figure, you can see here in this figure two walls we used, brick walls we used parallel to the as an end support parallel to the flight, or you can say perpendicular to the step width, known as slab spanning horizontally. In another way you can explain this, in this figure you can see two beams we used at both ends of the step, and in this figure we used one beam and second is one wall. So no matter what will be the support, whether that is beam or wall, the point is if there are two end supports provided parallel to the flight, maybe at the end of each step, or you can say maybe at the center. See another figure, you can see a stringer beam is provided at the center and that is parallel to the flight, known as slab spanning horizontally or transversely. This figure is also showing another example of slab spanning horizontally. These are different type of stairs, depends on end support. In this figure you can see there is no stringer beam on this side, but there is one support which is parallel to the flight, and that is this wall, and other part, rest part of the step is working like a cantilever. So this is also example of this type of stairs. So the point is the stair slab is supported on each side by side walls or by stringer beams or by a wall on one side and a beam on another side. This stair slab may also be supported horizontally by a side wall on one side of each flight and by a common naval wall on the other side between the backward and forward flights. Clear guys? This is about a first type of the stairs as per the end support. And one more important thing, is if the end supports will be different. Here two end supports are there in terms of wall, here in terms of two beams, here in this figure in terms of one beam and one wall, and here in this figure two beams. If the end supports are different, then you can see clear span and effective span in all the figures will be different. As we know, that is completely clear span and effective span is completely depends on the end support. As in this figure, clear span will be inner face of this wall to the inner face of this wall, that horizontal distance, that spacing will be clear span. And the effective span will be, as we know, that clear span plus half of the bearing on one side and half of the bearing of second side. Means here the meaning of bearing is that whatever the part of stair, whatever the part of step inside the support, that is a bearing. See, See carefully, this is let me show with the pen. Yes, this is known as wall width or support width, and this part of the step which is inside the support known as bearing. Clear? The part of the step inside the support known as bearing. So effective span will be clear span plus half of the bearing plus half of the bearing. That will be effective span in this case. And in second case, where two beams we used parallel to the flight at the end of each step, in that case half of the bearing to half of the bearing, that will be effective span, and inside distance from this inner face of the beam to the inner face of this beam, that will be clear span. Here also in this figure you can find that clear span and effective span with the same procedure. Clear guys? But this figure is a different, because here one stringer beam we used at the center and both parts are working like a overhanging and cantilever. So here clear span and effective span will be from inner face of this beam to this side, maybe inner face of this side of the beam to this end of the step, known as clear span. This is one clear span and this one is second clear span, and both will be equal. Clear guys? And one more thing, in this type of stairs where a cantilever part, a complete part of the step is a cantilever part. Here in this figure you can see we provided one support in terms of wall at the one end, and the complete part of the step is acting like a cantilever. So in this case the clear spacing will be a inner face of this wall to the whole length of the step, known as clear span, and whatever the part of step inside the wall, that will be bearing. So clear span, this clear span plus half of the bearing, there is only one bearing, so clear span plus one part of half of the bearing, that will be effective span. Clear guys? This was the concept of very first type of stairs as per the end support, and that is stair slab spanning horizontally and transversely. So next very important type is second type is stair slab spanning longitudinally, and the meaning of it is the stair slab supported at the bottom, at the bottom and at the top of flight. One more time, I am repeating the meaning of it is the stair slab is supported at top with this beam and at bottom with this beam of the flight. This inclined part is flight. So this flight is supported at the first step and the last step with the help of beam, maybe of wall, and the remaining, the complete flight part will be unsupported, known as stair slab spanning longitudinally. Here support, whatever the support, the beam, the wall, that support will be perpendicular to the flight, perpendicular to the flight, or you can say parallel to the width of step. So this type of stairs known as stair slab spanning longitudinally, and this is the second type of the stairs with respect to end supports. I am going to explain this type of stairs with two different examples. In first one you can see that I already explained the beams, the end supports are provided parallel to the flight near to the step only, in which the landing part, the rest landing part is working like a cantilever or overhanging. But in this part, see in this figure, we have to provide end support at the end of one landing and at the end of second landing. See, find out the difference between both the figures. In this figure, The end support are provided near to the step, starting of the first step and end of the first step. And in this figure, end spurs are provided at the end of landing on this side and at the end of landing on this side. Both are the examples of this type of stairs, but the working conditions of both the stairs, both the examples are different, because support to support length is known as span. Here in this figure, if you will see carefully, from this half of the support to the this half of the support, that horizontal length is known as span. But in this figure, from this support, half of the support to the this half of the support, that horizontal length is known as span. The difference is, in this span, length of landing is included, but in this span, length of landing is not included, because that is outside of the support. Clear, guys? So these are the two ways to explain the stairs lap spanning longitudinally, where one way is when the end support is near to the steps, excluding a part of landing, and the second way is when the end supports are there at the end of one landing, at the end of second landing. So see, this is another figure. Both the sections are visible here of the both type of, or both examples. Here you will see from half of this support to half of this support, this horizontal length, horizontal spacing is known as span. Clear? From this inner face of this support to inner face of this support, that is clear span, and half of this support to half of this support, that is effective span. But in this figure, half of this support to half of this support, that horizontal length is known as effective span. In this effective span, that landing length is included on both side, but in this figure, in effective span, landing of this side and landing of this side is not included, and both are the examples of slab spanning, stair slab spanning longitudinally. Clear, guys? So this was the concept of types of stairs with respect to end supports. And secondly, a very important question may come from this topic, that is how effective length or how span is depends on the end support in case of stairs. Or in another way, a question may come, what are the different conditions of end supports in stairs on which span depends. So okay, guys, I tried my best to explain this toughest part of the stairs easily, in easy way, with all the examples, with all the conditions of end supports. Thank you.